Hello and welcome to our Memorial Day celebration. Today we remember the men and women who have sacrificed their lives to preserve the freedom and liberty we all enjoy in our country, the United States of America.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance in the National Anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for our national anthem. States during the Civil War. He wanted a stronger federal government and was against slavery. It was his election that triggered the Southern states leaving in the Civil War. He was determined that the country would remain united.
In 1863, Abraham Lincoln made a speech at the Battle of Gettysburg that was extremely important. Although he says the world will little remember that we say here, the world noted that he and has not forgotten it.
47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing that nation, or any nation, so conceived and so dedicated can long endure.
We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who have gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this.
But in larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced.
It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we shall take increased devotion to cause for which they gave the last full measure of the devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under guard, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Can we please have everyone stand up for the posting of the colors?
We now invite the 5th grade band to play Balance, Warm Up, and Anasazi by John Anderson.
Thank you.
year on the last Monday in May, with gatherings at the South and North cemeteries.
During World War I, Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae wrote in Flanders Fields.
In Flanders Fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below.
We are the dead, short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields.
Take up your quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high, if ye break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders Field.
This poem is set to music by John Jacobson and Roger Emerson. The poppies mentioned in the poem are often worn on the lapels to salute our fallen warriors.
At dusk, during flag ceremonies, and at military funerals. Please stand and remain silent while taps is played and the colors are retired. Please do not clap after taps.